Hello everybody, welcome to this video. Basically, what I want to show you is a bit of code I've done with the HoloLens to track the hands, because I wanted to track the hands to know if it's the left or the right hand. As I don't have the HoloLens here in my hand, I will show you a video I've done earlier to explain you a bit how it's working. So, basically, here I've done the demo, where basically you can track the hands, but he don't know if it's a left or a right hand. And also there is some positional tracking here that at first I didn't know what it is about. Is it from Unity value or is it from the HoloLens value? And also the press time. It's a press time based on since when the scene has been loaded. So what I've done is I've done my own version here. Where I can track if it's the left hand, if it's the right hand. Basically, I take the first position, the first place where you find the hand, and based on that, I say that it is the left or the right. Also, the tapping, now if you tap, you can have this time since how many times it's typing, if it's track or not, and you can have the initial position, the last position, and you can have in terms of what HoloLens gave you, what it is compared to the world and what it is compared to the camera. So if you want to know if the hand is far from the central view of the user, you can say it's far from the left, far from the right, on the top, on the bottom. Also, I realized after playing with that here it's a local version of where the hand is compared to the camera. You can see that if I play a bit with that, I have a situation like this where you cannot detect the hand upper than the HoloLens, so it's really just in front of the HoloLens, a bit down, a bit on the left and a bit on the right. So take this in consideration if you do a HoloLens 1 application, because here the second is arriving and it will change a bit everything. So in terms of code, what does it look like? So here is the scene. Okay, I have the prefab here that is called hand tracking. I will not work on this code anymore. So basically, what you see in this video, it's what you will get if you download the code. So basically, I did first a script that is kind of raw. Basically, there is someone on the web that explained how to. Wait, I opened the Visual Studio. Someone on the web explained how to recover the hand. So I did it, but it was not working. It was not updated. So I did my own version based on that. So if you want the link, it's this link that is in the description of the code. So basically, pop, here is the code of the script. Also, I add some events. So if you just want to hear it, does one hand is down, up, or exiting the zone, you can hear it. But this code is kind of not readable in terms of usability, I will say. And also, it doesn't detect if it's the left or the right hand. So if you look at this code, feel free, but yeah, it's a bad one. It's not that it's a bad one, it's just not readable. So what I did, it's a second version here. So based on this one, so I just target this one that I've done from a script on the web. And basically what I'm saying, because here the positional tracking of the hand is based not of the Unity world, but based on the mixed reality camera parent. So what I'm asking you in the prefab is just to say, can you give me the position of the camera, and can you give me the position of the initial point of the tracking system? If you give me that, what you will receive is this. So data about is the hand is tracked, is the hand is tapping, is the hand is the left or the right, and since how many times it's tapping. Here I have a table with two hands, is because basically I'm putting the data here and then I try to convert left and right. Okay. So here, I will go in the code. All the information that you can have and that is not displayed over there because it's not serialized, it's the converted points. So basically you will have the last point detected, so where is the hand for the moment. The start point, the start tapping point is when you tap, I record the position. And the first detecting point, it's when it entered the view of the HoloLens it will detect this point. It allows you to let to know if it's a left or a right hand or a right hand position. So basically, if we look at converting unconverted position here, I go here. What do I store here is the whole position that is given from the HoloLens data and the Unity World position. So basically, I'll convert the whole position with the data you gave me to a world position, really easy to use now. And the camera local position, it's based on the camera. It's from the point of view of the camera, where is the hand in a local term. And so, yeah, I think it's kind of cool to have this tool. It can be handy if you do HoloLens 1 project, even if in the future it will change. I mean, now that we have HoloLens 2. So basically, as the HoloLens 2 is coming, HoloLens, the old HoloLens version will be depreciated. But if you want to use to know which version I have used, I show you here, Mixed Reality Toolkit. You go in release. Here, you go down, 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 down. Here is the new version that are coming, and I'm using this version. So currently, for the code I gave you, it was this version of the code, and for the so you just need to download this stuff, okay? And for the Unity part, currently I'm in this version of Unity. So what I will do is that if you ask me the code, I will just take those one and export, and there is this package that you will have. So feel free to use it. It's super useful for me. It was super useful for me, for my project and for my student. So yeah, if you're wondering why I have all this grid here, just to be able to measure and check that my data was all right. So yeah. Hope you enjoy, feel free to use. Contact me to have the code, because I don't want to give it freely like this to anybody. If you, I can give it freely, but I mean, yeah, I don't want to, yeah. Just ask for the code, I will send you the code for free. But if you use it for commercial purpose, try to give me a reward by offering me a beer or something like that. Thanks for listening, see you, goodbye.